Hey everybody, what's going on? I am Greg Sussman, joined today by Tom Vecchio of FanDuel. We're here to break down this weekend in the League of Legends. What's happening, Tom?
Nothing much. This is the start of playoffs. We have two games on Saturday, two games on Sunday. For myself as a fan, it should be a good time, but we also have some DFS to get to.
We do have some DFS to get to, and we're desperate for DFS. So it's good to be able to get in on League of Legends. So let's break down Saturday's matchups first. Two games on Saturday. You are all over it, Team Fanatics. How come?
We have the start of the playoffs. Two games on Saturday, two games on Sunday. It really should be a good time for myself as a fan. And then we also have some DFS action to get into. Starting off with the European matchup, Fnatic facing off against Origin. And when it comes to Europe, there are three top tier teams: G2, Fnatic, and Origin. We have Fnatic and Origin playing against each other, but this is a best of five series. So this could be, you know, a 3-0 sweep. It could be 3-2, which is actually what this series is shaping up to be. Two teams that are very good going head-to-head in what should be a close series, and that means more potential fantasy points. Obviously better to play, you know, five games than three. That's what we want to be focusing on. So we have Fnatic. Their top player is Reckless. He is one of the best players, if not the best player in Europe. You want to be starting your stack off with him. You want to be looking to pair him off with Hillsang, his support. There is a high correlation between ADC and their support player. That's where we get some double dipping on points, if you will. We can then look to Whippo in the top lane, along with going to Nemesis in the mid lane. That's the kind of riskier pick. I think Whippo in the top lane is a bit safer, but you want to be starting your Fnatic stack off with Reckless, Hillsang, and Whippo.
All right, there you go. Get in on the Fnatic stack there. A series of 3-2 gives you more opportunity to score points, so hopefully you'll take advantage of that on Saturday. Another team that's worth taking advantage of, it's the Evil Geniuses. They're in a good spot as well on Saturday. Why do you like them, Tom?
So EG are shaping up to be, this could be a 3-0 sweep against FlyQuest. This could be a 3-1 sweep, which obviously lowers the potential equity compared to going a full five games. They are facing off against FlyQuest. They beat FlyQuest twice in the regular season, 2-0, and these games were complete blowouts. Like, these were not even close. And then looking at FlyQuest overall as a team, they have 10 wins in the regular season, but six of those wins came against teams that aren't in the playoffs. So it's like kind of an inflated record, right? So we're saying, okay, they're in the playoffs, but really, how good are they? I'm fully expecting, and along with some of the analysts that I follow on Twitter, they are expecting EG to win this series. It's probably going to be a quick series. So we want to be looking to Jizuke, who is their mid laner. We have to be going with him. You can't be passing up on, what is essentially an RB1 as a home favorite, if you want to, pull up a comparison. We can't be fading an RB1. If you want a higher upside boom bust type play, Svensk Garen, their jungler, is also very viable, especially if the series goes longer. He would be a high variance player you want in tournaments. And then for a bit of value, their support player, Zazel, is also really interesting. I will say their AD carry, ADC, Bang, is only $100 cheaper compared to Reckless. And now, as I said, I expect that Fnatic series to go four or five games, while this EG series should only go three, maybe four. So there's an ownership standpoint to look at. Fnatic and Reckless should be higher owned, but Bang is kind of just as good as him, $100 cheaper, and should be lower owned.
A couple of different options there if you want to go with the Evil Geniuses stack, but as Tom mentioned, that series may not go as long as the other one we mentioned. Evil Genius is still a nice play for Saturday. Let's move on to Sunday, Tom, and we're going to take a look at a different region here. We're going to begin with Cloud9. What do you like about them?
Cloud9 are unbelievable. They are first in North American LCS. They are 17-1 in the regular season. The team tied for second was 10-8. So 17-1 to 10-8 is a pretty big differential. Cloud9 have had the number one seed locked up for weeks at this point. They are playing 100 Thieves this week, and really no one is expecting this to be a close series. This is going to be a steamroll. This is going to be a quick series, but even with that said, it is really, really, really tough to pass on a player like Zven, their ADC, who comes in with the most kills in the LCS, the highest KDA, is probably going to win the split MVP, even in what should be a short series. This is not a situation you want to be fading him. This is a four-game slate where you don't want to be fading Scherzer. He's the best pitcher. You play him. Zven is the best player on this slate. You do not want to be fading him. You should look to pair him with Vulcan, his support. You know, mix in Licorice if you're trying to get interesting. He's definitely not the highest upside player. I would think Niski, their mid laner, is a bit better. Cloud9 should win 3-0, but this is still not a team you want to be fading today.
Like Tom said, Cloud9 has had this wrapped up for weeks now, and they've been getting set for the playoffs for this matchup here. They're in a good spot. May not be a long series. Stats should be there for Cloud9. One more team that's worth talking about also playing on Sunday, and that's Rogue. What do you like about Rogue here going at it this weekend?
Rogue and Misfits, this is the 5-6 matchup for the European playoffs. So two teams that are good but not great. This is a series that we probably should see go 4 or 5 games. I don't expect either team to be dominant in either way. I kind of expect this to just be back and forth, maybe a little bit messy. You know, Cloud9 is that team that's going to be steamrolling. This game is actually where we can find some equity because it should go longer, although one team won't be dominant. When it comes to looking at Rogue, I think we want to be starting off with Larson in the mid lane. I think that's a very, very viable option, along with Han Sama as the ADC. Just given the makeup that we have on this slate, Han Sama is a player that you should absolutely want to be targeting. Vander as his support is another player you should be targeting. And I think that going to Zven and Vulcan is a viable combination, but pivoting off of them and going to Han Sama and Vander is a viable option as well. If you actually want to run it back and kind of do as a game stack here, going to Febivin, the mid laner for Misfits, who are playing Rogue, and going to Dandan in the top lane for Misfits is interesting because these guys aren't overly expensive and will still allow you to pay up for Zven from Cloud9.
Both Misfits and Rogue offer opportunity this week to get some other players in there. So consider wisely in this 5-6 matchup. Rogue, Misfits, both on the table for us here on Sunday. That's going to do it for us here on the FanDuel Hurry Up. Tom, we appreciate the time. Good luck this weekend.
Same to you.
All right, everybody, stay safe out there. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time for another edition of the FanDuel Hurry Up.